Hey, this is DJ from DJSTRAINS on YouTube. In this video, we're going to look at some of the classic roundhouses that are still standing in 2020. But before I show you them, I ask that you do not attempt to go inside these buildings as they are on private property. So starting our list, just northeast of Pittsburgh, is a little known railroad that used to exist known as the Unity Railways. Its four-stall roundhouse is located in North Bessemer, Pennsylvania, adjacent to the Bessemer and Lake Erie, now Canadian National Railroad Yard. Great photos like this can be found at the Greenville Museum in Greenville, Pennsylvania, or by clicking on the link, which will be in the description below. Today, the structure still stands, although the turntable and all the tracks belonging to the Unity Railway have been removed. Freight as well as passenger service was provided by the Unity Railway from 1915 through 1925 using one or two rented Bessemer and Lake Erie steam locomotives. In 1925, the Unity acquired its first new steam engine, a heavy Baldwin 280, number 25. A second locomotive, used Bessemer and Lake Erie 280, number 352, was purchased in 1944 and remained in service until 1953. In 1953, the Unity acquired a EMD SW8, number 53, and that was the first and only diesel locomotive owned by the Unity. So with that, you don't need to have a four-stall roundhouse. Roundhouses are made for steam engines, and it's not common to keep a diesel engine inside. But I'm glad the building still stands. Two great books that I own. The first is from Morning Sun Books. It is the Pennsylvania Short Lines in Color, Volume 2. There's a couple pages that feature great color photos and a ton of information with a picture of both the steam engine and the diesel. Another great book is Ghost Rails, Volume 13, Coal Runners. And there's a lot of pages in this book that have the Unity, the maps, drawings, diagrams, everything you could want to possibly know about the Unity. Wayne Cole did a great job on this book as well. Just east of Pittsburgh, located in the town of Hazelwood, is the roundhouse of the former Monongahela Connecting Railroad. Known as the MonCon, this railroad served the steel industry along the Monongahela River. The MonCon opened in 1887 and had both standard gauge and 3-foot narrow gauge track. It started with 040 steam engines, and in 1905 began using heavier 060s. It did pick up 4 big 080s, but it also purchased its first diesel in 1936. The MonCon pretty much went under in the 1980s with the collapse of the steel industry. The only tracks in the area are operated by the Allegheny Valley Railroad. So here's what I know. I do remember that the roundhouse was owned for many years by the Hance Locomotive Service. I am told that the building and the property now are owned by RIDC and also Carnegie Mellon University, which specializes in robotics in this area. There used to be a lot of brick buildings connected to the roundhouse. Those have been torn down. But it is interesting to still see a turntable. A lot of the roundhouses today don't have the turntable anymore. It's going to be very interesting to see how they develop this area. The whole Hazelwood and Glenwood area are being redeveloped. Parts of the LTV Coke Works that have been dismantled. It is really going under some interesting redevelopment. And be very curious to see what they're going to do with this building. Now for reference, I used the same book that I mentioned about the previous roundhouse, the Pennsylvania Short Lines in Color, Volume 2. The MonCon connected two parts of Pittsburgh. You had the south side, which had all the mills, and then you had the Glenwood and Hazelwood side, which had all the blast furnaces. The Monongahela Connecting Railroad sometimes could be confused with this next railroad, the McKeesport Connecting Railroad. Now we're looking at the Monongahela River, and this railroad bridge connected the Pennsylvania Railroad, then Penn Central, and then the Union Railroad into the town of McKeesport. Now the McKeesport Connecting Railroad was only like 4 miles long, and it served United States Steel's National Works. It connected with the Baltimore and Ohio, and also with the Pittsburgh and Lake Erie. And so we're gonna take a flight down to look at the McKeesport Connecting Railroad roundhouse. Now you could see both sides of the roundhouse without trespassing. The back you could see by going along the bike trail. It's part of the Great Allegheny Passage. And then there is a road in front of the roundhouse. Once again, we ask that you do not go inside the building or onto the property. So the McKeesport Connecting Railroad, they started off just like the MonCon with steam, with 040 engines, and then they upgraded to the 060s. And diesels, when they went to diesel, they used the Elko S2s. So when they didn't have a need for steam and they started to dieselize, they changed the track, got rid of the turntable, and put in a sand tower. So that's something you probably weren't expecting to see, where the turntable was removed. That's a sanding tower there. This great old brick even has a date of 1906 engraved into it. And there have been many attempts to purchase the building and save it for future generations. The best attempt was for a museum. And you can learn more about that through the Railway and Locomotive Historic Society, the Steel City chapter. Now, although the roof really needs serious repair, the brick is great. There used to be diesel inspection pits, but those have been filled in. And there's a lot of history to this area. The National Works, this is where they made a lot of pipe. And you can learn more about this also in that Pennsylvania Short Lines Volume 2. Really neat little building here, and I just don't know what it was used for. But it's a visually stunning building, an interesting location, a lot of history. And I have more videos coming where I'm going to be covering more roundhouses in the Pennsylvania area. So I'll leave you with one last look at this. I'll show you a drawing my friend Kevin did of this building. How cool is that? Alright, so if you haven't done so, please subscribe to my channel, DJ's Trains. I try to put out videos very often. Hit that bell icon so you can be notified of future videos. And also, you can follow me on Facebook under DJ's Trains, and Instagram and Twitter. And you can also buy merchandise on Teespring. I got more stuff coming to the Teespring site. It's really good stuff. I think you'll really like it. Let's see. Hey, I want to thank the Railway and Locomotive Historic Society, the Steel City chapter, and everyone that I used their pictures, and Teresa for helping me to fly the drone. And let's see. Oh, we got to thank God for the nice weather. Surprisingly nice this year. I want to thank you guys for watching. I want to thank my kidneys for not failing while I flew the drone, because I really had to pee. That's it. Go home. Why are you still reading this? Go see my other videos.